And as you can see on the board, we're going to talk about the responsibilities of a front office cashier. Now, before I go into the responsibilities, I would just like to give a brief description about the front office department as such. Front office is one of the core departments of the hotel, and it is involved in generation of maximum revenue for the hotel in terms of selling the rooms in the hotel. Front office, as the name suggests, is basically in the front of the hotel or front of the house. Front office is divided into different sections. I'll just write down the sections and give a brief description on each of the sections. The first one being telephones. Third one, reception. Fourth one being information. Next, the bell desk. Or there's another word for that, the concierge desk. And the last one, our main topic, being the cash section. Now, starting with telephones. Telephones is situated in the back office, that is behind the lobby, and it is basically taken care of by the telephone operators. They are completely involved in the handling of incoming calls. They also take care of wake-up calls for the in-house guests. Coming to reservations, the name tells that this is one section of front office which is handling the reservations or the booking of all the rooms that are available for sale in the hotel. Reception is the section in the hotel which is basically receiving the guests, plus they give the rooms or they allot the rooms to the guests who have come to do the check-in. Now, information is one section which may not be available in all the hotels. Now, as you walk into the hotel lobby, you can see the front desk counter. The front desk counter can be divided into two sections, or it can be divided into three sections. If it is divided into just two sections, one section is reception and the other section will be the cash section. But in case in certain hotels the counter will be divided into three sections, then it will be the information section, the reception, as well as the cash section. Information section basically handles of the hotels in certain places. Otherwise, they also give information not only about the hotel in terms of about the rooms, then the facilities that are available in the hotel, the various functions that are happening in the hotel, plus they also give information about various activities that are happening in the city. Nowadays, hotels may not really require the facilities of the information section. Instead, we have what is called the concierge desk, which handles the work of the information. Other than that, the next section is called the bell desk. Bell desk is taken care of by the bell boys, and they are supervised by the bell desk supervisor. Bell desk is basically handling the luggages of the guests during the check-in as well as during the check-out. Now, hotels have come up with a new concept, which is the concept of concierge desk, which has been taken from the American hotels. Concierge desk is manned by people who are basically known as concierge. They are a level above the bellboys. Concierge, they not only handle the luggages of the guests during check-in and check-out, but they also provide a lot of personalized service in terms of, you know, booking the tickets for the airlines or for the railways, as well as booking, not taking reservation for the tables in restaurants, plus a lot of other extra services are also given to the guest. So this is the work of the concierge desk. Now coming last to the cash section. I'll just go completely onto cash section. The cash section is handled by the cashiers. Now in a hotel, it has to be manned 24 hours a day. So we will have cashiers in three different shifts, in the morning, in the afternoon, as well as in the night shift. Now, depending on the number of rooms in the hotel, the number of cashiers cashiers in the cash section will definitely vary. Now, cashiers, as the name suggests, the cashier should be very apt in handling money. Now, they don't not only handle money, but they also have to handle credit cards, plus they have to handle checkouts. Now, to come to the responsibilities of the front office cashier, the moment the cashier comes, you know, to his shift or reports to his shift, the first thing he has to take care of is something known as the cash float. Cash float, as you can see, it basically tells that the cash is floating. Now, how is the cash floating? The word float basically means, when we think about float, it is in terms of water. The water is flowing in as well as the water is flowing out. In the cash section, the floating is basically the money. The money is coming into the cash section as well as going out of the cash section in terms of the transactions that are happening between the guests and the cashier. Now, to give it in a simple example, suppose we go to take photocopies to a particular shop. Now, the shopkeeper has opened his shop in the morning and we go to take the photocopy. I take a photocopy for about 6 rupees and I give the shopkeeper 10 rupees. So what do I expect the shopkeeper to give me back? He has to give me back 4 rupees. Now, in case he doesn't have any change with him, he opened the shop, he didn't keep any change with him, how do we expect him to return that 4 rupees to me? So what happens is, in terms of his practice or the daily work that he has done, he should be knowing that he should keep a sufficient amount of money with him carry out the transactions for the day. In that way, a lot of transactions happen throughout the day between the guests and the cashiers. So the cashier also has to keep a lot of money with him to do the transactions. And that amount of money that is kept by the cashier to carry out the transactions is basically known as the cash float. Now, again, depending on the number of rooms that are there in the hotels, the management might decide on the amount of money that can be kept by the cashiers. Hotels with about 100 rooms might keep a cash float of about 50,000 rupees. But certain other hotels can keep a cash float which ranges from about 80,000 to about 1 lakh rupees. That really helps the cashier to do all the transactions between him and the guest. Now, that is the first thing that the cashier needs. Other than that, the work done by the cashier, I'll show in terms of a